Presenting data in the right way can convince everyone in the room that you're the go-to data person. It builds the trust you need to run with your ideas because people know you're going to do your due diligence. Welcome to Funnel's YouTube channel, where we talk all things digital marketing, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer. Alrighty. Making a dashboard can be quite fun. It's turning your data into pretty charts with fun colors and using it as a way to get across the story you want to tell. Dashboards not only make your data look more fun, but they can also help us see patterns and correlations in numbers that are challenging to see otherwise. If you think about it, that's what your dashboard should be. A riveting story told through your data. Is it obvious how much I like data? Big data guy, big dashboard guy. Anyway. So, how do you tell that story more clearly so everyone understands who the main characters were, what they did, and make sure they're on the edge of their seats to see, well, what happens next? In this video, I'll cover my top 5 tips and tricks for making your dashboards more actionable so next time you present data, you see a lot of impressed faces. Tip number 1. Choose the right type of visualization. It seems obvious, but I would guess that a lot of us don't always take the time to really think through what the message is of the specific visualization that we're including in the dashboard. It's easy to take the first suggestion of, let's say, a pie chart, but that is not always the best option. For example, if you're trying to convey the message that Google Ads traffic has accounted for a significantly higher number of conversions this past month compared to your other paid channels, well, a pie chart isn't going to get your message across as quickly as you may think. That's because it's challenging to see the differences clearly in a pie chart. Instead, use a good old bar chart. This way you can show in an instant how the channels stack up against each other. Key takeaway here, ask yourself, is this a visualization that's going to get my message across as quickly, simply, and clearly as possible? You can even place the Google Ads channel farthest to the right and have the other channels in ascending order based on the number of conversions they brought in, so the viewer's eyes quickly go to that point. This leads to my next tip, location, location, location. Tip number 2, use placement and position to help you tell your story. Where you place things in your dashboard and even in individual visualizations can help your audience understand and connect the dots faster. Again, you can think of it like a story timeline. First, this happened, and then this, which leads to us having an amazing that for this month. And in conclusion, we're going to try and do it again, but with these new changes to see how that impacts the that. Stay tuned for next month's episode. You're welcome. I'm making the business flourish with my genius marketing reporting and analysis. Lastly, on tip 2, consider the natural pattern for how viewers read and use that to draw their eyes to the data you want them to look at first and where you want them to end. Tip number 3, focus your audience's attention with color. Color can be great, but there is such a thing as too much color, so be careful here. Our eyes are automatically drawn to color, so use this to your advantage when creating a dashboard. And have the most important metrics, i.e. the ones you need your audience to focus on, in a pop of color. Here are 2 easy things to do to level up your dashboards when it comes to color. Number 1, reduce the amount of colors you use. Keep it simple. Don't aim for making a dashboard that looks like a Kandinsky painting. Number 2, remove color from or grayscale the metrics that just aren't that relevant. If we go back to the example of Google Ads bringing in the most conversions, you can grayscale out all the other channel conversions and put the Google Ads channel conversions in a brighter gradient or even a different color. Tip number 4, using size to focus attention and show relationships. This one's pretty straightforward. To show which data points are larger than others, you can make them different sizes. The larger the measurement, the larger the visual representation. Something to keep in mind is don't go against human intuition here. Meaning, if you want to focus attention on the smaller data sets, don't make them larger. Keep them small, but grayscale the other bubbles and make them pop with color. Tip number 5, use action titles. The titles of visualizations and even the overall dashboard is often overlooked. I don't know about you, but sometimes I can get lazy with what I name them. But this often overlooked real estate is literally the place where you can tell your story. I'm gonna go back to my agency days here when Make Index was a big part of the job. My manager at the time, who was amazing, really drilled into me that the titles of each slide were super important for telling the story you wanted to convey. The title had to succinctly tell you what the slide was trying to say so people could easily follow along. Instead of naming the graphic where you explain the great Google Ads performance, conversions per channel, you can name it Google Ads has the most conversions and highest conversion rate. It gets the message you want across quickly, and viewers really don't have to think about what you're trying to say. They have the action title, and then they can look at the data visualization that confirms it for them. One quick caveat though, if you're creating an automated weekly or monthly dashboard where the goal is to consistently check in on it with a team or management, then a title like conversions per channel is probably better. So everyone knows which widgets they're looking at week on week or month on month, and they can more easily spot the trends. Now, there are plenty more ways you can make your dashboards actionable. These are just my top 5 tips and tricks to easily get started with. That's it for today. If you found this video useful, like and subscribe, or you'll get more videos about digital marketing, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.